Hey, hello, hi, welcome to my YouTube channel Tech Grantha. So today on the Lotanar tutorials, we are going to discuss about the correlation things. So how we are going to correlate any of the dynamic value and how we can capture the left and right hand boundary. So I just take the example of JPET store application. So there you can see, like, whenever we will launch the application, and if you select any of the category ID, right? So you will get, if suppose I selected the dog, so you will get the category IDs like that. And on the top, you can see some JSON ID is captured there. So now what the objective is there, we are going to capture that JSON ID on the Lotanar script. So I already recorded the flow. Now what the enhancement I need to do, because the correlation I told, we need to put the correlation code just above the one request where actually we are getting the dynamic value. So if you see, that was the my correlation, like that is my request. So I need to put the correlation code top of that request. So how we can find out the left and right hand boundary? So what I will do, I will go on that specific request, and then I'm going to expand that one. And there you can see if I will go on that things, so now you can see there is a JSON ID and that information, right? So I put the code on there. Okay, so let me copy that one. So I just copy that portion, and for your understanding, I just paste the code there. Now I need to find out the left and right hand boundary. So the syntax is like the Webrex save param, then parameter name, I just given the JSON ID, and the left boundary. So the left boundary is nothing like just before whatever the value is there, that is comes under the left boundary. So I just put the JSON ID equal to, that is my left boundary. And right boundary, the correlation, like the dynamic value, has been end at the 3. So that view category, I just take the preference as the right hand boundary. Okay. And after that, that parameter name I am going to replace with the curly braces, because on that request here our dynamic value has been came. So I just modified, and there I just replace that value as the JSON ID. After that, now I am going to execute that script for two iteration. I just given the two iteration, so we can easily cross check, like exactly we are getting the every time the JSON ID is different or not. So I just replayed the scripts. Now it has been run successfully. So I need to find out the JSON ID. So I just copied that one, and I'm going to paste that thing on log. Okay. So now the first JSON ID, which is started with 37E6, right? And the second, you can see, which is started with the 6A54 something. So that means my correlation code is successfully working properly. Now the second thing which I am going to discuss, so for example, I am going to correlate those category also. Okay, so what I need to do, because on that category I am getting do that one. So what I will do, I will just go on that, and we'll go on the source page, and on the source page I will find out there the dog. So I can see there is the all values is came there. So what will be the my left and right boundary? So that also I just modified. So what I did there, so that is my syntax, that is I just given the parameter name is like the category 1, and the my right boundary, left boundary is category ID equal to, and the right hand side boundary is that much. So I just went there, and I'm going to comment that line. I'm just going to enable that one, and there I replace the category 1. So now again I'm going to replay the same script for two iteration, and I will see it is going to pick on the different category ID every time or not. So that has been ran successfully. So now I need to see on the log how it is captured. So I just pasted there. So the first time it is picked up the fish, and second time Okay, it is picked up the fish value. I just given the gestation and category ID syntax is like that. So okay, so because see why it is picked every the fish every time, because I didn't give any of the other ordinal concepts. So ordinal concepts mostly we are using to array values. So there is a multiple, right? So if we are not going to use ordinal, by default it will pick the first value. So now I will just give the ordinal equal to all. So it will pick the all values. So I will just again replay the script and we'll see what the modification is came there. So let me okay, do one thing, just better first we will discuss about the basic concepts. So we'll go on that way. So better the my objective was to show you the gestation ID whatever we captured, and with that gestation ID we are getting the two different gestation values every time. Okay, sorry, I need to comment that one. Okay, now I just replay the script again and it will work properly. Okay, so now that has been worked successfully. So that's the way you can capture your correlation code, and the further next sessions we will do the some little bit more enhancement how we can pass the random values on there. So that will also discuss. So if you have any other doubt you can just put on the comment box and let me know your doubt clarification. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks to all.